Good morning, students. Welcome to today's session. I hope everyone of you understood what and all we have seen so far in the last classes. And we are seeing now the extra sums in coordinate geometry and also optional exercise. So this extra problems is not inside the textbook, but we are going to solve them with the concept of the coordinate geometry only. Okay. So let us enter into today's session. So before going to that, just a recall. The basic formulas. Okay, so in coordinate geometry, so first one distance formula. The application of distance formula is nothing but you can find out the distance between any two points in the coordinate plane. Okay, so that is the respective formula already we have seen in the last classes itself. And the next one section formula. The application of section formula is nothing but we can find out the coordinate point which divides a given line segment in the given ratio, right? And then next one, area of the triangle. So if three vertices are given, means how can you find out the area of the triangle? So that is the formula. Okay, this one already we have seen in the last classes itself. Okay, so today we are going to see some extra problems here. So look at the question here. The center of the circle is 2a comma a minus 7. So find the values of a if the circle passes through the point 11 comma minus 9 and has a diameter 10 root 2 units, right? So let us enter into solution video now.
Right, what is given here? The center of the circle given and diameter 10 root 2 units given here. So the circle passes through the point 11 comma minus 9. So they are asking to find out the value of A here. Right? So O is center of the circle. Now O, what is OA now? OA is the radius. Right? And here we are going to find out the unknown value here. Okay. So OA equal to radius, and it is half of the diameter, right? That is 10 root 2 divided by 2 here. If you simplify this, means we will get 5 root 2. So OA equal to 5 times root 2. So now we are going to find out A value only. So what is OA? The radius as well as the distance between this point and this point. Okay. Now we can use a distance formula between O and A. So root of, so this one x1 over x2 y2. So x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus, so plus 9 whole square equal to 5 root of 2. Right? Now remove the square root by squaring on both of those sides. Okay? Now take the square here. So it will become 2a minus 11 whole square plus, so here 7. Sorry, it's a minus 7 plus 9. If you simplify this, you get a plus 2 whole square. So equal to this will become, so 5 square 25 and root 2 square 2. Okay, after squaring on both of the sides. So how can we simplify this by using a minus 3 whole square power? So a square minus 2ab plus b square plus, similarly here, a plus b whole square, a square plus 2ab plus b square equal to 15. 25 into 15. Now, let us simplify this one. 4a square minus 2 plus 4. 4 levels are 44. So 44a plus 11 square 131 plus a square. And if you multiply, means plus 4a plus 2 square 4 equal to 50. So keep a and r here and remind while everything on the right hand side. So 4a square and here also 1a square, totally 5a square. And how many a's are there? Here minus 44a, here plus 4a. So minus 40a. And here the numbers also here. So 121, so plus 125. Bring this 50 left hand side and you know minus 50 equal to 0. Now simplify this. So 5a square minus 40a plus 75 equal to 0, right? Now find the common factor, so divide it by 5. So a square minus 8a plus 15 equal to 0, right? Now it is a quadratic equation with the variable a. Now we are going to find a only, so solve this. So here 15, so here minus 8. So what are the factors will come? So minus 3 minus 5. So if you multiply it with 15, that means minus 8. Okay, so add the variable this, so a minus 3 into a minus 5 equal to 0, therefore a equal
Look at the next example. If the points A of 1 comma minus 2 and B of 2 comma 3 and C of A comma 2 and D of minus 4 comma minus 3 form a parallelogram. So find the value of A and height of the parallelogram taking AB as a base. Look at the solution now.
So here ABCD is a parallelogram given, right? And the four points of the parallelogram also given here. And here A is unknown coordinate in C. So we are going to find out the value of A. And also they are asking to find out the height of the parallelogram also. Right? So here the diagonals are AC and BD. And they have the same midpoint O, because according to the diagonal property of the parallelogram, the diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. Therefore, O is the midpoint of both of the diagonals. So here midpoints are same. Therefore, midpoint of AC equal to midpoint of BD here. What is the midpoint formula? So ME equal to x1 plus x2 by 2, comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Okay. Now find the midpoint of AC now. So x1, y1, this one, and x2, y2. So 1 plus a by 2, comma minus 2 plus 2 divided by 2 equal to and midpoint of BD. So midpoint of BD. So x1, y1, x2, y2. So 2 minus 3 minus 3 by 2. Right? Simplify this now. So 1 plus a by 2 comma, so here minus 2 plus 2 0. So 1 plus a comma by 2 comma 0 equal to, so here minus 2 by 2 comma 3 minus 3 also 0 here. Right? Now equate the coordinate of x on both our sides. So 1 plus a by 2 equal to minus 2 divided by 2. So 2 get cancelled here. Therefore, which implies 1 plus a equal to minus 2. What is a now? So a equal to minus 2, it will become minus 1. So a equal to minus 3. So that is the value of a now. Right? So the points of a is nothing but 1 comma minus 2 and b of 2 comma 3 and c of a comma 2 and d of minus 4 comma minus 3. Right? So next, so here a value have to be found, that is it will become minus 3, that is c of minus 3 comma 2. Right? So next we are going to find out the height of the parallelogram. Right? And they are asking to use AB as a base. Right? So height of the parallelogram we need D here. So we know the area of the parallelogram, that is B into H equal to area of the parallelogram ABCD. Right? So here we need to find out height and also base. Right? So first we are going to find out base now. Okay, what is the length of the base? So that is the base AB. What about the length of AB? So how can we find out the distance of AB here? So by using distance formula only. So AB equal to square root of, so these two are AB. So x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. Right, now the distance from A and B, that is the distance from A to B is the same, AB equal to root of 1 minus the whole square plus minus 2 minus 3 whole square. Right? So equal to root of, so minus 1 whole square plus minus 5 whole square. So equal to root of 1 plus 25 equal to root of 26. Therefore, the distance between A and B is root of 26. That is the distance of the base, or the length of the base. So the length of the base is nothing but B equal to root of 26 unit. Okay? Units. So that is nothing but the length of the base. Next thing, we are going to find out the area of the triangle ABC. Okay, generally we can go to find out the height of the parallelogram. So area of the parallelogram ABCD equal to, so this is of one of the quadrilateral. So it is nothing but the sum of the area of the two triangles ABC and ABC. Okay, so area of triangle ABC plus area of the triangle ABC. Right? Now first we are going to find out the area of the triangle ABC. Right? So A is 1 comma minus 2 and B is 2 comma 3 and and C is minus 3 comma 2. So area of the triangle ABC. So what is the formula? So half into x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1